Thank you. good evening. Thank you for joining our Spring Percussion Ensemble concert. I'm Julie Strom. You just heard Cadence by Andy Pape. It is, as you could tell, it is our organized chaos piece of the concert, much like this last year for many of us. That was our sole drummy piece on the program tonight. The rest is all about marimba. Not intentionally, it just worked out well during COVID to program pieces with limited setting up, and using marimbas is pretty ideal for that. So the next piece, called Sleep, by Eric Whitaker, was originally written for singers and set to a Robert Frost poem. But legal battles ensued and the rights were eventually pulled, and Eric Whitaker wasn't allowed to use the poem. So he commissioned another poet, Charles Anthony Silvestri, to put lyrics to the score, and Bobby's going to read the poem for Sleep.
The evening hangs beneath the moon, a silver thread on darkened dew. With closing eyes and resting head, I know that sleep is coming soon. Upon my pillow, safe in bed, a thousand pictures fill my head. I cannot sleep, my mind's a flight, and yet my limbs seem made of lead. If there are noises in the night, a frightening shadow, flickering light, then I surrender unto sleep, where clouds of dreams give second sight. What dreams may come, both dark and deep, of flying wings and soaring leap, as I surrender unto sleep, as I surrender unto sleep. Thank you.
Percussion World, written by Steve Reich in the minimalist form. It is a duet that requires a lot of skill to stay just on track throughout the piece. So as meditative as minimalist music can be for the listener, the players are having a completely different experience and have to remain totally focused. As soon as we get set, this will be Owen Nagel and Bobby Bucknell on Nagoya Marimbas, two of our excellent freshmen. And we'll hear that in just a moment. Thank you. piece on our brief program tonight is both movements. Sometimes only the second movement is done, but we are doing the piece in full tonight. Daniel Levitan's Marimba Quartet. This piece has two movements, like I said, and is probably best described as subtle in one word. Levitan wrote it with some extended techniques for the players, like muffling the bar after it's played, which is almost never done, and creates a really specific kind of abbreviated resonance. Not to mention, it's also challenging because you have not only to play your notes, but muffle in perfect rhythm as well. He also calls for ghost note playing, which you'll hear right off the bat in the first movement. This sound, in combination with the non-ghosted notes, makes for a really syncopated, fun, jazzy kind of feel. And that's what makes it fun to play and listen to. One reviewer said it's got the same amount of transparency as a Bach sonata, but with far more rhythmic tracks to fall into, as I think they would all agree with. Anyway, thank you so much for joining us tonight. I know as players and as musicians being on a stage with an empty audience in front of us, it is not quite the same, and I know for you as listeners and viewers watching a screen is not quite the same, but thank you so much for your support, not just of our concert, but any concert for any musician right now. Even just knowing that somebody's out there and watching virtually means so much to us as musicians. That's what we do it for. So thank you for joining tonight. I hope you enjoy Marimba Quartet by Dan Levitan.
Thank you. Thank you.